You've probably noticed a major spike in panhandlers since the pandemic started.
We wanted to know, who are these people at intersections across the area? And what's it like being out there begging for money? And how much are they actually making? NBC2 investigator Evan Dean went undercover to find out.
It's often said the best way to understand someone.
There's usually a panhandler on this corner right here.
Is to put yourself in their shoes. So that's exactly what I'm doing, panhandling myself. I won't lie if I'm confronted or lie with my sign. The money will help. I'll donate it all to the Homeless Coalition. My first hour at Busy Daniels and 41.
See how this goes.
My first realization.
Busy intersection.
This isn't very safe or comfortable.
Whew, it's hot.
But so too did I quickly realize.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Just how generous our community is.
Thank you.
When I had time, I told people exactly what I was doing.
Oh, I felt bad, kind of, you know. I mean, I got a heart, you know. I just saw you standing out here, and I just figured, you know, maybe even if it's just a couple dollars, if everybody gives a dollar or two. Yeah.
I also realized out here,
there are three of us at this one intersection.
I wasn't alone. This woman and her fiance, this man, also panhandling. He agreed to talk if we didn't ID him.
Homeless, out of state, God bless, please help. And this is all true.
Yeah, that's true, yeah.
He says he lost his job when the pandemic hit, has three kids. They're staying with grandma, but he and his fiance can't. Says they sleep behind restaurants by night and panhandle by day.
Should people trust what they're being told?
I mean, ultimately, you want to believe what someone's saying or what someone has on the sign. I'm not trying to con anyone. I'm not trying to go, you know, do anyone wrong like that.
My second hour on the streets, we set up at a new spot.
Hey, thanks, man. Hey.
And the generosity grew.
Thank you very much.
Actually, we feel very passionate toward people of the less fortunate.
You know, what compels you to give like this?
Just what we do.
But I'll admit, at certain points,
been out here,
it was a struggle.
Walking up and down and not.
I got skepticism, dirty looks, some yelling to get a job. Didn't feel great.
You're at the bottom of your ladder.
Yeah.
This is the only thing left that you have to do.
That's Tim Gilligan. He says he's been homeless and panhandling long before the pandemic, for some 3 years.
I've been staying over there at AAA, right there what? Lately, last week, yeah.
What do you mean, staying where?
Just lay down on the ground. That's where I sleep.
In several cities and situations, panhandling isn't actually legal. Records show Gilligan has been arrested for doing it and arrested for having drugs several times over the past few years.
What do you say to the people who say, why don't you get a job?
Why don't you help me get a job?
Of all the people we met out here, the most surprising takeaway was the takeaway itself. I made more than $80 in just 2 hours.
So $40 an hour, yeah. So I said, I've heard people can make up to $400 in a day.
Janet Bartos leads the Lee Homeless Coalition, where we're donating the money.
What's the motivation for someone to get a real job if they're pulling in a few hundred bucks a day doing this?
Right, I guess there isn't.
Bartos actually discourages people from giving to panhandlers. She worries it's unsafe. She also worries not everyone is who they say they are. And for those who are homeless, she says this isn't the best way to help them.
We want to get the people off the streets. I know sometimes that may be their only way of making any money, but we would rather connect them to services and get them into housing. Housing is the only thing that solves homelessness.
For the NBC2 investigators, I'm Evan Dean.